The atmospheric pressure and winds. Atmospheric pressure. Air has weight and it exerts its weight as pressure on the surface of the earth. This weight of air is called atmospheric pressure. It is measured with the help of an instrument called barometer. The normal atmospheric pressure at sea level is about 76 cm of the mercury column in the barometer. The pressure varies from place to place and time to time. It depends on the temperature and altitude. The pattern of pressure distribution corresponds with the temperature belts on the surface of the earth. An area which is hot will always have rising air currents and thus will form low pressure region. In a cold region, the air is cold and heavy and descends downwards causing high pressure in that region. Pressure belts. The variations in pressure show a pattern of major pressure belts. Equatorial low pressure belt. Equatorial area is a region of high temperature. The atmosphere heats up in this region, expands and becomes lighter. Hence, the air starts rising up, creating a low pressure belt in this region. This belt is called doldrums or the region of calm condition. There is a complete absence of surface winds. Subtropical high pressure belt. This belt extends between 30 degree and 35 degree latitudes in both the hemispheres. Here, the winds are comparatively dry and calm. This is a zone of descending winds. The descending air starts to pile up and collects near the tropics, creating a high pressure belt. This belt is also called the horse latitude. Subpolar low pressure belt. This belt extends around 60 degree latitude in both the hemispheres. The rotation of the earth causes low density by swinging the air in the direction of the equator. This results in partial vacuum, creating a low pressure belt. Here, the air column is so thin that the air can hardly exert any pressure. Polar high pressure belts. Around the two poles, the temperature remains low and thus a permanent high pressure develops over the poles. They are called polar high pressure belts. All these pressure belts are not permanent in character. They keep shifting to the north and south with the movement of the sun. It is the temperature which controls the pressure belts. When the sun moves from one tropic to another, the pressure belts also do the same. This is called shifting of the pressure belts. Wind system. When hot air rises and creates a region of low pressure, cold air from neighboring high pressure areas moves towards low pressure areas. This horizontal movement of air is called wind. The instrument used for recording the direction of wind is called wind vane. The speed of wind depends on the pressure differences between two regions. When the difference is high, the wind rushes from the high pressure region to the low pressure region at a great speed, as in a storm. The speed of wind can be measured with the help of an instrument called anemometer. Winds can be broadly classified as permanent winds and local winds. Permanent winds. These are the winds which blow throughout the year in a particular direction and over a particular region. They are also called prevailing winds or planetary winds. They are of these types. Trade winds. They tend to blow from high pressure to the low pressure area, but they are deflected to the right in the northern hemisphere and to the left in the southern hemisphere. So, the trade winds blow from subtropical high pressure belts towards equatorial low pressure belts. In the northern hemisphere, their direction is northeast, and in the southern hemisphere, their direction is southeast. East being the common direction, they are also known as easterlies. In olden days, they were helpful for traders. That is why they are called trade winds. Anti-trade winds. They tend to blow in the opposite direction of trade winds. They blow from subtropical high pressure belt towards the subtropical low pressure belt. Their direction is southwest in the southern hemisphere and northwest in the northern hemisphere. West being the common direction, they are also called westerlies. Polar winds. They blow from the poles towards the subpolar low pressure belt. Their direction is the same as that of trade winds. That is why they are also known as polar easterlies. Local winds. Winds that arise due to any local or regional changes in the temperature and pressure are known as local winds. They affect small areas over a shorter period of time. Some local winds like monsoons, land and sea breezes are periodic. They are also called seasonal winds. Monsoon winds. The word monsoon is derived from Arabic word mosem, meaning season. They blow from sea towards landmass in one season and then from land towards sea in the other season of the year. The complete reversal of these winds is their characteristic feature. During summers, the landmass heats up rapidly and an intense low pressure area develops over Central Asia, which attracts the winds from the high pressure area. As a result, the southeast trade winds cross the equator and bring heavy rainfall to the large parts of Asia. These are known as summer monsoons. During winter season, the landmass becomes cooler and the pressure over Central Asia becomes high. From this high pressure area, the winds blow towards the equatorial low pressure area in the northeast direction. These are known as winter monsoons. Sea and land breezes. Water takes longer than land to get heated and cool down. During the day, the land becomes hotter than the sea. The air above the land becomes hot and rises, leading to a low pressure over the land. Since the air above the sea is cooler, the pressure above the sea is higher. So, the cooler air from the sea moves towards the land during the daytime. This is called sea breeze, which brings down the temperature in coastal areas during the day. At night, the land cools down much faster than the sea. The air above the sea is warmer and lighter. The warm air above the sea rises. So, the pressure above the sea is lower than the pressure above the land. Therefore, air from land blows out towards sea. This is known as land breeze. Local winds. Some winds with special characteristics blow over limited areas and have local significance. They have different names in different parts of the world. Loo. It is a hot and dry wind which blows over the plains of North India during summers. Chinook. It is a warm and dry wind which blows over the eastern side of the Rocky Mountains in North America. It is also known as snow eater. Fawn. Similar to Chinook, it blows down the southern flanks of the Alps during winters. It helps in ripening of grapes in southern Europe. Cyclonic winds. These are irregular winds of short duration. They are caused by the pressure systems called cyclones and anticyclones. A cyclone is an intense vortex or a whirl in the atmosphere with wind circling around it in anti-clockwise direction in the northern hemisphere and clockwise direction in the southern hemisphere. The center of a cyclone is a low pressure area with steep barometric gradient. In a cyclone, the wind blows at a speed of 150 to 250 km per hour. Indian subcontinent is often hit by cyclones. The cyclones hit the Arabian Sea coast as well as the Bay of Bengal. The states of West Bengal, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu along the Bay of Bengal and Gujarat and Maharashtra on the Arabian Sea coast are most vulnerable to cyclone. Super Cyclone 1999. A severe cyclone hit Odisha on 29 October 1999 with a wind speed of nearly 300 km per hour and incessant rains that lasted for about 48 hours. The region hit by cyclone was inhabited by poor fishermen who lived in thatched huts. Their homes were destroyed by the strong winds and the flowing floods. More than 10,000 people were killed and 15 million people were left homeless. Vast areas of farmland were flooded, causing damage to the standing crops. This was perhaps the most destructive cyclone in India in this century. Trivia: wind is powered by the sun. In fact, all renewable forms of energy and even energy in fossil fuels ultimately comes from the sun.